Hello friend, welcome you all to my channel Learn Innovatively with me. My name is Sasi Vosar Chauhan and today I am going to show you that how you can create a real-time gene experiment setup in Quant Studio software. So I am using the desktop version of Quant Studio software and you can see on my laptop screen. Here you can see the interface of the Quant Studio design and analysis software version 1.4.3, and to create new experiment you can click here, or you can open an existing experiment from here, and you can also create new experiment by clicking on the file and new experiment setup, and you can also use the shortcut key Ctrl plus N to create new experiment. So I am starting from here. Here you can see the step involved for the experiment setup: property, method, plate, run, results, and the export. In the properties section you can see name, you can rename your experiment, barcode, username, these are optional, and the instrument type. Here by default it is Quant Studio 5, but if you want to change you can select drop down menu, and you can see here this software can also be used for the Quant Studio 3 system, but I am selecting the Quant Studio 5 system. Block type 96L 0.2 mL block, but if you want to change you can select the drop down menu and select your block type. I am leaving the default 96L 0.2 mL block. And the experiment type, here by default it is standard curve, and if you click here you can see there are other option for the experiment type: standard curve, relative standard curve. But today I am showing the setup for the comparative delta CT value, so I am selecting this. And the chemistry, I am selecting the Tecmon reagent, but if you want to change you can change from here. And the run method, it is standard, but if you want to change for the fast run method you can change. In the fast run method the reagents are different type, and if you have the reagent for the fast experiment setup you can select the fast method here and click on the next. Here is the experiment method, and the first is the volume of the reaction. I am selecting the 20 microliter, by default it is 50 microliter. And leave the cover temperature as such. And here is the stage of the PCR cycle, hold stage and the PCR stage. And if you want to add one more stage here, you can click on the plus button and select hold or cycling. You can see one more stage added. And to delete this, just click on the minus button, the stage will be deleted. And to add the step, here you can see, here is the option to add the step. If you click here on the plus button, one more step is added in the PCR stage. And to delete this, just click on the minus button, the step will be deleted. And to change the value in the hold stage and the PCR stage, you can change according to your choice, like the temperature. If you want to change the temperature, just click on the temperature and change it. And time, you can also change it. At every stage according to your choice you can change. And here you can see the camera icon is highlighted, it means data will be recorded at this stage of annealing. And here you can also see the there is no any extension step. In most of the real-time reaction experiment setup the annealing and extension step are merged together. And in the last you can see the PCR stage cycle, how many cycle you want to run your PCR. So by default it is 40, but if you want to change you can change it and click on the next. In the plate setup, assign target and sample. For this here is two methods, quick setup and the advanced setup. I suggest you use advanced setup, it provides the more option to set up your experiment. So first is target. So by default target 1 is present here, and the reporter diaphragm and the quencher NFQ MGB. And to add more target, click here on the add button, the next target will be added in your target section. And you can rename the target. I am selecting the 18S as an endogenous control of my experiment, and the gene of interest CTLA4. And if you want to change the reporter, if you click here you can change the reporter dye for the 18S target, but I am using the FAM reporter dye for the 18S. And like this for the quencher, you can also select the quencher according to your reaction mixture. And for the CTLA4 you can also change accordingly. And in the sample section, to add the new sample, just click here. So I am selecting the, so I am adding the 8 sample. And if you have using the biological replicate group, you can select from here. And after assigning the target sample name, you can assign this sample and target in your plate. So to assign the sample and target, select the well. I am selecting the first two column. I have added the target 18 years, and you can also see the U, and this is the task type. You can see here in the, this is unknown. And the, for the next two column, for the CTLA-4 and for the negative control, I have used the negative control for 18 years and CTLA-4. I have added the sample here. So I am selecting the well and assign the target, and in the task type, select the negative control. This is for the 18 years, and like this, this is for CTLA-4. So in this way, you can assign your sample and target and negative control in the plate layout. So click on the next. So after setup property method plate, you can save your experiment here at your desired location. And after saving the experiment, I suggest start run, and laptop is not connect with the machine. So here it is showing none. Make sure your machine is connected with your system and start run. Thank you for watching my video. I hope this may help you in your research. And if you like the video, please subscribe my channel. Thank you.